Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the World of Wayne and happy Friday. Today we're going to be doing pack 2 of the Agora models release and build the New York fire truck. Excited to get this. As a matter of fact, this comes in two boxes. One of them I've got down here because it's ginormous, but I'll share that with you when we come to that side of the build. Now, if you want to get this for yourself, I've put the link down here. It's also in the video description, and you can get this all the way from pack one. And over at the Agora model site, you've got 9 items, I think, at the moment, just going into the end of the year. And they include things like the Terminator, the Cobra, the Bismarck, the Zero Fighter. There's loads. Go check that site out. But can't wait to get jumping on board this. So without further ado, let's get cracking. You know what? I'm beginning to think it should be a staple of every builder's workshop to have a kettle in there. I haven't got a kettle in here. So I've had to just rush into the house to get some hot water because we're going to be working on the tires first off. So what I'm going to do is just soak one of these tires in this hot water. And just keep that to one side for a second while I just open the other parts up. Now we've got a rim here, so I'll just get that open and I'll just open this section here, which is the ladder nameplate, which has been very protected, but I'll get this out so we're ready to go with that as well. All we're going to be doing first is we're going to be pushing this rim onto the tire. Now you've seen this hundreds of times on the channel. So I will fish this out, try and dry it off as best I can, and then it's just a case of pushing this into the tire. Now, the hot water is just going to make that quite soft, so we can get this all the way in. What I do is I do one side first. These tires are a little bit smaller than I'm used to, but it's the same technique. So as you can see, that tire's on no problems at all. Let's put the water to one side, dry it off, and as you can see, with the nameplate here and the tire, that's all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 10 here, we're going to be doing some more components for the cab roof. And if you remember, in pack 1, this is where we're up to on the pack roof. So I'm going to put that to one side and we'll get this open. All the parts, as you can see, are individually wrapped here. What I need first is just the surround here for this other condenser grill. We get this out, and the first thing I'm going to do is we just need to touch some glue just into the inner rim of this section here so we can actually stick the grill to it. So I've got some glue already lined up for that, and I'm just going to run that inside the inner channel here one this side, and I'm just going to spot it on the other two sides there. That should be enough. Get the grill here and then just put the grill into that section, push it down so it goes into the recess, and then the glue will hold that in place, no problems at all. Now this condenser frame is going over the condenser, and all we've got to do is push these in. The pins are the same size, but apply pressure just over the pins and then that will snap in exactly like what we did on that side there. Now, similar to what we did last time, it's going to go on this side here. The pins or the lugs are different. You've got a thicker one and a thinner one. So just line them up to where they're going to go and then push that into place. 1, 2. So it's nice and flush along the sides there. And that's both of those in. Now, we've got our first red light bar here. Obviously, we've got the white one there. And that looks like this. And in a similar fashion to what we done last time, we're just going to be putting this all the way through. I'm not undoing the wires. I'm going to keep them nice and tidy on that wire tidy for now, and just push this into place. So again, that fits nice and flush in there like that. We're finished with the top section for now, so we can put that to one side, and we're going to start working on the suspension and parts that we are going to eventually mount the front wheels to. Get everything out. I think that's the best way to tackle this. Also got a fire extinguisher there as well. Okay, so if we have it this way round, so the longer arms facing away from me here, we are going to be putting these track rods in place. So this one is going to go this way. So this section here is pointed towards the longer sections, just going to go over the top there. And we're going to do exactly the same on the other side, just mirroring what we've just done. over the top. Now we've actually got the track rod, which looks like this, which is going to go underneath the hole section on this side. We're going to push that in. There we go. And we're going to do the same on the other side. No glue. You can hear it fits quite cool in there. So when we actually turn this now, as you can see, the wheels are going to turn. Which means all we need to do then is take the wheel that we created earlier, making sure we put it on the right way. And we're going to be putting it on this side here first. This is the right wheel. And we're going to push that on firmly like that. It's going to be kept in place with one of these L screws. So lining that up. And we'll get this in. Now you don't want any wheel wobble. So it's nice and tight. I have actually put some oil on that, even though it's plastic. It just does help to drive the screws in. So you can see the wheel turns, but there's no wobble there. All we got to do then is take the coil springs here and put them on the axle posts. One and two. Getting the suspension going here, aren't we? And that is all there is to do in that stage. Remember, we do have a fire extinguisher still from this stage. So in stage 11, we're going to be doing the left-hand side light bar. We've got some parts of the chassis in here as well. So just like we did in the last stage, we'll just get the light bar out. This one's just going in the opposite side here. Now I'm just seeing how they locate it. You see you've got one notch here and two notches at the front. It's the two notches at the front that they've got in on their sections here in the pictures. I think I'm going to have to turn my middle one around to match that. I don't know if it matters, but now I've noticed it, my OCD is going to be playing havoc with me. So I will make sure that all of my lights here do have these two notches facing forwards. See, so I'm going to turn this one around as well. And now we are uniform on all the lights. All the other parts that we've got in here, the exhaust and the chassis parts, we don't actually use in this stage, so we can keep that to one part, one side, because that's all there is to do in that issue. Now, stage 12, we've got some components for the front bumper and front right stabilizer, which means we do need to bring over the front bumper that we worked on in the last pack. Take this plating here, and that's going to go on top here. Now we want it so that the lug inside here is going to match that hole just there, and it should line up all the screw marks as well. So that's going to go in just like that. Now it only gets pushed into those, it will hold itself in no problems at all, so you want to make sure it's flush. We've got a bell that we're going to be putting together here. I love the detail on this, look at that. This bell is metal, just so you know. So I'm going to push the little ringer, clanger, I don't know what it's called, inside the bell like that. And then this is going to go into the two holes you can see in that plating here. I'm just seeing if they are different sizes. There is one slightly smaller than the other one. So just line that up and then push them in. See, I do think there's a danger there. If you push that too hard, it's not going to, it's going to break. So just be careful of that. But that's the bell in place. It won't come out, as you can see. In this little pack here, we've got some tow hooks. So we get them out. And in a similar fashion to the bell, we're just going to push that side in. We're just going to push those into the slots here. So one in this side. Then make sure that goes all the way down. And one in the other slot there. Then we've got a stabilizing bracket here, which I'm going to get out. And when you hear me drop this, you can tell that there's some metal in there. Now this bottom piece is definitely metal. I think the case is plastic. It's hard to tell when you've got this much paint on it, I have to say. We're going to be putting this against the front bumper here. So this is going to go through the hole at the side, and it's going to go over the lug that you can see inside there. So it's going to go on like this, then fit on just like that there, with this silver side facing out. It's going to be held in with a size J screw, which is in this pack here. Put that all the way in, and that's the first stabilizer in place. And then once again, we do have a part here which looks like one of the mirrors, which we don't actually use in this stage. We'll keep that safe, but that is all there is to do in that stage. may have noticed, I'm clearing up my workstation because stage 12 is in this ginormous box here. And yes, you've got it. We've got the full chassis of the fire truck in here. So I'll get this out and I will show you what this looks like. Now this stage is actually called 12B. This is all metal and I'm going to put it up so you can see how big it is against me. Absolutely ginormous. But we're going to be working on this in this stage. So I want it this way round and we're going to be working on this section first. Now we need the front part of the chassis, which we had in stage 11. That looks just like that's there. Put this into place. So it's going to go into this section here. So the hole here is going over the hole just there, like that. It's going to be held in from the other side with a size H screw, which is one of the silver screws here. So turn that over and just put a screw through this side. Then we've got the next part of the chassis, which looks like that. Now this is going to go on this section here, just behind the section we just put in. Once again, we've got a locating lug and a screw hole. So it's going to go in just like that. Turn it over. And then once again, you've guessed it, we're going to be putting a size H screw. So that's just going to go support it from the bottom into this hole just here. Excellent. Now we want outrigger pads, which look like that. Turning this around, these are going to go onto these points just here. Now, if I put one in just to show you what this looks like, you can see we've got locating lugs in there. It's going to go in this way, push one in, so that we can actually see it from that side like that. These are glued into place, so I need to get some glue onto this. So what I'll do is I'll put some glue just around the inside here. One and two. And then I'll put this part in. Make sure it's flush. And then we're going to do exactly the same thing on the other side. That's perfect. Then we're going to be putting in these cab steps here. These are going to go towards the rear section here. Let me just show you that. They're going to go into this section, probably on the top camera here and here. Be careful of these steps. You've got two different sizes. You've got long ones here. And if I can find them, you've got shorter ones. It's the longer ones that you want. But once again, putting glue on these. So I'll put it around the lugs. One and two. And one in the middle, just for some luck. And we're going to be putting this on first. That's one on that side. And do exactly the same just on the other side there. So then we've just got the smaller steps now. And the smaller steps are just going on the very back. Let's just move this over so you can see that. Just on the very back section here. In exactly the same way. So one this side. You can see my glue sticks very quickly. So now they're all in on that side. And I'll turn it round. Just show you the other side as well. Now we've got some wheel arches to put on. These are just going to go over the top of this section here and they're just going to align to these pins. And you want to make sure when you put it in that this cutoff section here is facing inwards. So it's going to go on like this on this side. One, two, three, and four. And then we do the same on the other side here. One, two, three, and four. Now, once we're happy with how these are going to fit and we've got the orientation right, we just need to put them in with a little bit of glue along the flange here. This time I'm just going to dot this on. So in three spaces I think would be enough. Again, my glue is very easy to stick down. And then just hold that into place until that's stuck, and we're going to do the same on the other side. Now once you're happy with that, we're going to be putting the chrome ones here onto the front of the vehicle. And in a similar way, we want the curve here to be following the curve over this side. Just going to do a quick dry fit to see how these are going to go in. They're going to go onto the pins all over here, which means, again, we can put just a little bit of glue just around this inside flange here. Now, the pins are pretty much what's going to hold this on. So I'm pushing that all the way in. And that's one on that side and just repeat that for the other side there. Now you are sticking plastic to metal, so you do need a good CA glue. Now my glue's from a company called The Range in the UK, but something similar would be just a Loctite. If you've got a Loctite glue, it's pretty similar. So I'm pushing that down to make sure that's on securely as well. We're then going to be taking this part, which we worked on in the last pack, making sure we've still got all the springs in place on this. And that's going to go underneath the chassis here into these four holes, with this long shaft coming down here and then the lug on this section just going into the hole you can see at the top there. But as I've just noticed, when we put this in, we need to actually put this drive shaft here, let me show you on this, into the hole just at the bottom of that section there. There we go. Then we can line that up. That's good. That's in place. And that's in the hole where it needs to be. Great suspension on this. I do like that. So we've got some L screws to put in here now. Lots and lots of them to hold that all into place. So let's put one in this side first. There's 10 screws in total, so I think it's probably best look at the picture and I will get all of these in. So I'm just putting the last couple of screws in here, and as you can see, when I'm putting them in, I don't over tighten them. Basically, I'm putting them in and as soon as I feel resistance, I'm stopping. I'm not going too tight at all on these because I do want there to be some spring in the suspension. So there you go, they're all in, and as you can see, we've still got lovely suspension in here with this being able to move. Now we just got this last cross member to put in. That's going to go into the two holes here. The lugs are different sizes. You've got a smaller one and a larger one, so just line them up, and this is just going to be pushed in. So push as hard as you can to get them in. And there we go, that holds that into place. So then we're going to take the exhaust. This is metal, just so you can see, and if you have a look here, we've got two holes. We want to put it on the one nearest to the drive shaft here. And the other side of this section is just going to go on that hole there. So it's going to go in like that. And that's going to be held in with a Type H screw. The Type H screw, remember, is the silver metal one. That's just going to go into here. Make sure that that other end is lined up with that hole. It's only one screw you're doing to secure this in. Excellent. So you've got the exhaust in as well. Keep that here because we've got the cylinder. Again, this coming stage 11. That's going to go just into this side here. Again, one locating lug, which I'll put on. And the other side of that's going to be held in with a C screw. Different screw this time. It's a silver one, but it's quite a small one there. So I'll get that screwed in as well. There we go, that's the cylinder in place. Then we're going to be putting in just this little cross member here. That's just going to go into the hole at the bottom. It is shaped, so it should give you an idea of how it goes in. It sort of goes in at an angle all the way down, but that's in like that. And then finally, the wheels that we created right at the beginning here, looking like that, we're going to be mounting into place as well. They're going to be going on the front here, but we need to make sure we put them around the right way. So the longer sections are towards the front of the vehicle. I'll probably put this on its side again, actually, when I put this in, just to line everything up. Just like that. Looking good on both sides. And then we can push each pin into the corresponding holes on each side here as well. As you can see, bouncing up and down. But we are going to be putting that into place with size L screws again. They're the flanged ones. So I'll put one in this side. That should hold everything down. And one just in the other side here. Just like that. So now that's in place. You can still see that they can turn like that. And that is all there is to do in that stage. What a big stage that was. Once again, just having a quick tidy up here. Stage 13, we're going to be the components for the cab central console. And that's looking like this. We've got a speaker which has been protected very well. Let's get that out. And on the end of that console, you can see where the speaker is going to mount. So it's going to go this way around into this section. So the wires are coming out the bottom here. Now the wire wants to straddle the plastic that we have got at the bottom. So when it's in, it should look like that there. We've got a cover to put over the top, which again is individually wrapped here. Get that out. That's just going to go over the top here like that. Keep all of that into place. And that's held in with a Type C screw. Got that in here. These are the small silver ones here. So one in that side and one in the other side here. So there we go. That's the speaker installed perfectly. Now we've got some handles. They're going to go on the central column. So the first one's going to go in here. It's quite loose on mine. So I think I am going to just drop some glue in there to keep that into place. So one here. Excellent. And then just one on the other side. We've got an axe. I don't know why that made me laugh. We've got an axe. Look at that. Check that out. We've got an axe. That's just going to go into, turning it around here, into this side here. You can see we have got a locating lug just at the bottom of the axe. So we can push that into place like that. So I've got some glass here, actual Perspex. We'll get this out. All to do with the cab, so that's looking like that here. As you can see, we've got two holes in the middle, a larger hole and a smaller hole. I need to take the central console storage like that, and as you can see, we've got the corresponding holes on this side, so we just need to make sure this goes in the right way. It's going to go in here, line that up. So that's what that should look like when it's done. And then we just take the center console here, and the slot at the bottom here is just going to go into that slot there, so we line it up. And then just push this home into place. We do have this little tiny engineer switch panel to put in. That's just going to go into the shaped socket there. Again, it's just a push in. And that is all there is to do in that stage. So stage 14, we're working on another door. We've done this before. So first thing I want actually is one of the seats, and again we've done this before as well. I will give you an inventory of everything that we've done so far, just so you know where we are up to on this. We've got a base to put on, and for that we are going to have to put a little bit of glue just on the bottom of this base, on the flat side, not the side with the lug. So I'll put some glue just on this middle section here. And we're going to be putting it on the seat so the lug is actually pointing towards the back section there. Push that down. There we go. That's engaged into that. Going to take the cab door. Lots of little details on that. And we've got the handle here. So I'll just get out. Quite simply, that's just going to push into the hole here. Again, it's shaped, so we just need to make sure we put this in right. I want to make sure that's fitting flush there. You heard that click into place, so that's the handle in. Turn it over, because we've got a little tiny gear to put into the other side of that handle. So it has got a sort of like shape again, as I said, so get this on. So that's in. So as you can see, that now moves around. Then we've got the door, which has already got a window in this. I think I'll make sure the window is already up, and this is just going to engage with this part here on top like that, so when it's all fully engaged I'll be able to operate the window. Now this is glued onto the pegs here, so I'm going to just dab some glue on each one of these, not a lot, 1, 2, and 3. And ensure we put this in so that the gear engages on that window there. So before I push it down, just want to make sure that operates the window, which it does. As you can see, they're going down and up. Excellent. that's fully into place. I'm happy with that. We're going to be putting this onto this inner panel. So that's going to go onto this section here. It's going to be glued into place. So once again, I'm going to drop some glue just into this panel. And then push that home. Excellent. And then if I just open that again, just onto the panel of the door there, we've got this little silver latch. Again, it can only go in one way. Little bit of glue again. Not as much as I have been putting in, just a little dab there to get this part in. So that's another door and another seat completed. And that's all there is to do in that stage. Now, stage 15, we've got the cab floor and the engine seat. And with the cab floor, we're going to take the console that we worked on, and we're going to be putting that over the top in this direction. So this fits on like that, making sure I'm not pinching anything, which I'm not. That looks perfect. That's going to be secured in with type H screws. So I've got one in this side here. And one just in the top side here. Now, I am making sure that the wire for the speaker is coming out the bottom. I don't want to be caught out with that later on, you see. But when that's in place, that looks like that. Put that to one side, because we've got a seat to put in. Now the seat is going on a base here, and we're going to be making sure that the flat end like this is facing towards the front of the seat, and this is just a push-in. Funny material, this seat, I have to say. And that's going to go into the center console here. It's going to be going onto this side just over here like that. That's going to be secured in from the underside, once again, with an H screw. I found it easy to actually just remove the seat first, put the base in, and then press the seat in afterwards like that. So there we go, that's the seat in. We've got the seat that we made last time looking like that. That's just going to go into this point here. Once again, held in with a tight H screw from underneath. So now that is looking like that. That looks really good, doesn't it? We've got a thermal imaging camera. That's just going to go into the D-shaped slot just at the back there. Now, obviously, because it's D-shaped, it can only go in one way. But push that hard and that will go in. Then we've got a halogen bar. That's what this is called. That's just going to go into the holes next to it here. Don't know if you can see that on the top camera, but I'll push this in. You can check that they've all been installed, because you should be able to see the pins through the other side here. I think I've got one side of that halogen bar that needs to go through. But as you can see, they're all through now. Now we're going to be installing some magnets here. This is going to be fun to get out of this packet. Now I'm going to turn the console over here. And if you look at the magnets here, we've got a red line. That red line is the side that's going to stick to the part here. Now, I've already got one in this side here, one in this side, one in this side over here. So I need to just make sure that this one's put on this side here. Now, these have already been pre-installed. I don't know if that was intentional. I haven't done that. But the instructions are telling us just to install this other magnet here, which I'm going to put in now, making sure that the red line here faces the wall of that section. And there are some parts left over, but that is all there is to do in that stage. Which means in the last stage, stage 16, we're going to do some components for the mobile data terminal, wing mirrors, cabin side roof, and dome lights. Quite a few things here. Let's get all this out. So the first thing I'm going to do is just take out the little case, which is the base of the MDT frame. And we have got a little computer keyboard here. So I'll get that. And we are just going to be putting a little bit of glue just onto the center of this here to hold the keyboard in place. Just holding that for a second. I'm going to be putting some glue just on the back of this terminal now. Notice that I don't swamp this in glue. Because we've got the screen. Get this out of this pack here. And that's just going to follow the indent of what we've got there. Push that in. That's just going to go into the center console here. As you can see, we've got two tabs on the bottom there. They're just going to go into the holes there. So line it up and then just push that in. So as you can see, that's the console in. Put that to one side, because then we've got the inside roof, which looks like that. And we've got some little dome lights to put in here. And these are just going to push into the holes that we can just see here. Now they are shaped. I'm just going to see how they fit. If they are too loose, it is saying just apply a tiny bit of glue to them. And as you can see on my one, yep, I don't think I'm going to get away with not using any glue. So I'm just going to use a tiny piece here, just on the inside rim of each side. Push this in. So that's one. One on the other side here. And that one's two. Making sure they're in okay. They look good. We don't need that now. We can keep that to one side. Now, we do have some mirrors here to put on, and they just go onto the door here, just like you see on the picture. But it is recommending perhaps do that later in the build, because they can snap off quite easily. And I think I'm going to take that advice and not put them on, but they're there ready to go. But what with that and that, that's all there is to do in that stage. So let's have a look what we've done in this pack. So we've got the door, we've got the headliner, we've got the top of the cab where we've put some more stuff in, we've got the front with the bell. We've got loads of parts left over, like another mirror here. We've got a fire extinguisher. We've got this bracket here. We've got a steering wheel and what looks like a tire. I don't know what that is, actually. And I've still got loads of screws left. And also this little plate here that we don't do anything with. We've got quite a lot left over, you see. But the big things are the console that we've done with the seats. And obviously, who can forget the ginormous chassis that we've been working on with the wheels? We've got one wheel in at the moment. No, we've got two wheels. One here, one on the other side over here, or two on the other side over there. I enjoyed that. That was quite a fun little build to put together. If you want to get this for yourself, once again, I'll put the link to the Agora Models website down below, and you can get this all the way from pack one. But I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, have a great weekend. Take care.